everyone. It's Mike Mixon from Keyboardamerica.com and .co here in Lewis Beach, Delaware. And welcome to this video series on setting up your Genos step by step. Now, I'm going to be doing three videos on this. This is the introductory video that's extremely important because I'm going to give you an overview of the Genos and why we're going to set it up the way we're going to set it up. You're going to need a notepad and a pencil or something to write with so that you can jot down some notes because you're going to have some decisions to make. You might want your Genos set up a little bit differently than I do for your style of playing. But the first thing we have to do is give you an overview of what we're doing and why we're doing it. So let's take an overview look at the Genos and get started explaining to you everything that we're going to do in this series. There's also going to be a little bit thinking about what to name this new bank. So we're going to be talking about that in the video as well. So let's get started and take a look at the overview of the Genos. Okay, so when we're creating the new bank, we have to do everything that I'm going to show you right now and just store it on one of the registration memories. Once we do all this work to store the first one, from then on, you won't have to redo everything that we're doing here. And in fact, you'll be able to make some simple changes as well on your Genos for each registration memory that you have. So the one thing that I'm going to want to program, and before I go any further, the direct access button is your most important button on the Genos. So one of the things I'm going to want to program is this rotary assignable button. Now this rotary assignable button can do different things, and there's also some other settings that we're going to use that you're going to hear about here too, but that's something to think about. We also are going to want my vocal harmony and my mic setting programmed into the first one for sure. I might want my auto fill in, my OTO link, my accompaniment on. Before I store, I'm definitely going to store the assignable buttons that I choose. And all this is going to be in the second video, step by step on what to do first, second, and third. Now, there are a few things on the Genos, and we're looking at volume levels here. The right one volume, if you're storing one sound in there, I like to put it up at 127. So once again, we're going to be storing a lot of things in that first registration memory in this new bank that we're going to create. I'm also going to want to store my custom one-touch settings for each song into my registration memories as well. There's going to be a couple different ways that you can save to these registration banks. And when I zoom in here in a couple seconds, you're going to see what I'm talking about. The first thing we're going to do is take a look at the assignable buttons, because that's one of the important steps that we're going to have to do. And I'll give you an overview. And now it's time to maybe get ready to jot some notes down. All right, keep in mind that if you bought your Genos from us here at Keyboard America, all this work is already done for you and it's loaded into your Genos. So, but it's always good to learn how to do this. So the first thing I'm going to do is hit direct access and assignable A, because I want to set up my keyboard before I store that first one, so I have a great foundation. It's like building a house. You have a good foundation, you're all set and ready to go. Now I'm going to zoom in just a little bit further. Okay, now we're zoomed in. On A, I've got my channel off and on. On B, I have my score. On C, I have my lyrics. On D, I have my vocal harmony. E, I have my mic setting, and on F, I have my keyboard harmony, which gives you a single finger chord in your right hand. Now, some of you may use your pedal to control your keyboard harmony off and on. And we're going to be getting to that later in video two, the first time we set up for this. Now, so this is where you want to start to think. When you push A here on the screen, you've got 12 pages of things. You want to look through there and see what fits you. I have the channel off and on there because I use my big USB stick with all my MIDI files on there, and all the MIDI files that you get with the Genos from us are all number one hits from the big band era all the way up through the 80s. All number one hits, and that's on my big stick as well on the Genos. So when I go to channel assignable A, there's my channel off and on right there, so I can quickly turn off the lead note on that MIDI file in case I want to play over top of it or sing over top of it. I don't want the lead note going, so that's why I do that. On assignable B, I have the score, and that's the score of the MIDI file that's playing, or any score. On C, I actually have the lyrics, and you want to make sure it's on song B. I have the lyrics of the song on that MIDI file. On D, I have my vocal harmony, so that when I want to change my vocal harmony, I can just touch it and choose the harmony that I want quickly. So these are like shortcut buttons right here to do what you want to do. On E, I have the mic setting with reverb and things like that. And on F, I have my keyboard harmony where I can change it. So they're just great shortcuts. Even if you're using your pedal to turn your harmony arpeggiator off and on, this is a great button to set it up. Because keep in mind, you're going to be able to store different harmony arpeggiators in every one of these registration memory buttons. So each button can be stored differently. So that's why those assignables need to be programmed. So what you want to do is think about what you use the most, and you just get to that page. Now, in order to assign it, it's very simple. You know, you're going to hit your direct access and your A button and start to look through the lists of what's on there so you can decide what you want. Or you can set it up the way I have mine set up. Okay, now it's time for our thinking caps again. How do we want to set up this registration memory bank? Well, there's multiple ways you can do it, whatever suits you fine. Let's just say that you've got your top, I'm going to go to preset because that's what your Genos looks like. Let's just say that you have your top R&B style that you like, and you might want to store that in number one. And you can store a different style, like your top 10 styles in there, as well as your favorite 10 sounds in there. You can do it both, which is what you might want to do. I do mine a little bit differently because I program my OTS for each song. Once again, I am going to cover that in this video, but it would be great for you to watch the saving to OTS step by step and access it from my webpage, my Genos Tyros video lessons room, so you get the right video. Make sure it's step by step, okay? So basically, I'm going to store my top 10 right hand sounds and settings. And that doesn't matter whether some of them are layered or not. Now, we're going to take a look at something real quick here so that you can see exactly what I'm talking about. All right, so we know we're going to program your top 10 favorite sounds in here. That's one way to do it. Now, in my instance, I called that bank Bank 1A. And, you know, that could be named anything, but that's where I have my top 10 sounds. And when I have my freeze button on, I can play any style and use my top 10 sounds on there. So on number one, I have a piano concert grand. On number two, I have that 60 shadow guitar. On number three, I have the great breathy tenor. And I've altered these sounds, gave them a little more reverb as well. We're going to cover that. On four, I've got my Hold It Fast organ, as I use that an awful lot. On five, I have a theater organ and a music box mixture. On number six, I've got my cocktail grand and strings. On seven, I've got a romantic clarinet. On eight, I've got an entire sax section. So there's three sounds stored in there. On number nine, of course, I have my Glenn Miller sound, which is really always nice. And then on number 10, I have my big brass Glenn Miller. So that's what I have stored in there right now. Now, I can go in here now, and I will store my favorite rhythm, top 10 rhythm styles in here. So even though that's stored with my top 10 sounds, at this point, if I want to hit my style button and I want to go back to preset, and I want to go to jazz, and I want to do big band crooner, okay? I can actually, at this point, hit memory and one, and that big band crooner is going to be stored in that bank 1A, okay? So I can put a different style, my top 10 styles in here. Now, I'm going to have one set up like that in this video. It's going to be called Big Band because I'm making a new bank for you to show you how to do this. But I use mine a little differently than that. So I'm going to switch registration banks right now. And because I made a change on that bank 1A, it's saying the current registration bank has been changed. Do you want to save it? Yeah, I'm going to save it. And I'm going to save it there in the bank 1A. Bank 1A comes up. Okay. It already exists. You want to overwrite? Yes. And there we go. I am finished saving that, so I'm not going to lose that. Now, the way I have it set up is when I go to different banks, so bank 4, for instance, is what I'm working on right now. I'm going to turn my freeze off. And what I've done is because I've saved to OTS for each song that I did, it gave me the opportunity to rename the file from Big Band Crooner to something else. And for instance, on the style here, I used a big band count for this week's song that I did and just released a little while ago, Don't Get Around Much Anymore. So because I stored it in OTS and changed the name of the style from Big Band Count to Don't Get Around Much Anymore, when I push number 9, you see Don't Get Around Much Anymore comes up. So once again, your thinking cap, if you want to have it set up the way I just told you a few minutes ago, you can do one bank like that with your top 10 favorite sounds, your top 10 favorite styles, and then the next bank you create, you could start to create one of these for each song that you do, like I did. Next week's song is going to be At the Hop, and I've already got that programmed in. So the last 10 songs that I did on my class are right here. Big Girls Don't Cry, Tammy, Just the Way You Are, Rock Around the Clock, Nobody Does It Better. And everything is programmed in here, by the way. If I zoom out, you'll see that the right introduction is on. Everything is perfect. Perfectly set up for me to play that song without me thinking about a darn thing, even if I change the tempo. So you can see the thinking cap here has to go on to see what you want to name your banks, and you can set it up differently on each bank, but it's important to program your assignables. Now, it's going to also be important to program your memory button properly, and once again, this will be in video 2. This is just an overview. So before I save this first one, I want to make sure my entire Genos, everything that I want it to save from now on, is going to be there. All the assignables that I picked up, all the boxes that are checked in the memory, because each one of these can be stored differently, but all your main settings will be there. And you can actually go in and edit, for instance, the vocal harmony, or you could edit the single finger chord, the harmony arpeggiator. So you could have a different harmony arpeggiator for each one of these songs, but keep in mind all your basic settings are going to be in the Genos. Okay, another thing you're going to learn, I have 3 pedals hooked up to my Genos. So if I hit my direct access and I hit my smaller pedal on the floor, you can see it says rotary slow and fast. If you're playing B3 setting, Hammond organs or whatnot, you might want to have that there. Most people would rather have the harmony arpeggiator on. So that's what most people would want. So all you have to do is hit direct access and the pedal, and you got to set all this up before you store your first one. Now they can be altered for the other ones a little bit. You can customize for each song like I'm going to show you to do in the video, but you can see how many things you need to do before you save that first registration memory in your new bank. And once again, regardless of whether your Genos is new out of the box, or you know you've already got bank saved like I do, and I haven't really named mine properly on my video, but bank one, you know, that should be called class 1 through 10, the first 10 songs that I started storing. And by the way, since we're thinking about that, when I hit the style button, when you're on preset, it looks normal, right? But when I program the OTS for each song, that's how it gets stored into user with a new name. And you can see Nobody Does It Better, Oh Holy Night, Santa Claus, Rocking Around the Christmas Tree, On the Sunny Side of the Street. And they're all programmed into my registration memories. So you might want run registration bank with your favorite 10 sounds and then your favorite 10 styles, and then you start your next bank after you've watched the saving to OTS step by step, and start to put one bank for your first 10 songs, the next bank for your next 10 songs, because all I have to do to play a song is literally hit this and start playing, hit my chord. So, you know, if I go into this week's song, Don't Get Around Much Anymore, here's Unforgettable on 9. I'm not going to touch another button. I'm just going to strike my chord. So So you can tell now on number four, I had my harmony arpeggiator giving me a full chord in the right hand, where on one I don't. And all these I programmed for unforgettable, I can still hit the freeze button and use my top 10 favorite sounds if I want, because that freeze button is going to allow it to stay on the same style, even though I've programmed styles in here in my banks as well. That's a great way to use it. The other things I want to think about too before I store in here is my tempo, because this is where the tempo saves. When you store into OTS and you store your top four sounds for each individual song in there, that does not save the tempo there. That's why you save it here in your registration memory. Eventually, I can make a playlist by going up and hitting the playlist button and can work it either way, right here from my registration banks, or I can work it from my playlist. But if you sing, you might want to transpose in a different key on each registration memories. So you can see how much work has to go in to setting up that first registration in that first bank. And that way, and this is the clincher right here. When I go to do my next song, as long as I start out on that first registration bank, and now I go look for the style and change my voice and everything else that's there, now it's going to remember, because I'm going to hit memory two. And once again, this is going to be in the second video and the third video of this video series. Everything is going to be step by step. Okay, so that's kind of an overview of why we're doing things and why it's so important to do all this work on your first registration in this bank. So the only thing you have to think about right now is how you want to set up your Genos registration banks, and what do you want to call those banks. You got to put your thinking cap on and think about how to do it. Now, here's how I would do it if I were you. I really like saving my songs with my OTS in my registration banks. I really do. However, you can have one bank with your top 10 songs with just the styles and not the name of the song. It doesn't matter. You can do it that way and make that bank. And then when you go to make another bank, which you're going to see in the videos, then you could start that bank with each one of your songs with all the custom little settings that you're doing for each song. Because your harmony arpeggiator button, your single finger chord in the right hand, you might want that a little different for each song. You might want a trio, you might want a duo, you know, you never know what you want, but you can tweak it on each one. But as long as you start on the registration number one and then go out and start to get your settings set before you put it in number two, you don't have to do all the stuff that we're going to do in the initial setup on video two. That's going to be done. You won't have to do that again. All you're going to have to do is tweak each of the registration memories for what you want to change for the song that you're playing. So video one now is ending. I would say to you, be a good time to watch saving to OTS, because I'll be making the second video probably tomorrow. It will be up. And once again, if you go to our website before you go to YouTube, you can see the videos right there. It's going to be a lot easier for you to find the videos, because I have over 200 videos on there, and you might search YouTube for a while. Go on our website, go on our video lesson page, and you'll see those videos right at the top. Okay? So until video two, this is Mike Mixon from KeyboardAmerica.com saying have a great day, keep playing, and see you on video two.